Welcome back to my channel and welcome if you're new here. Thank you for stopping by today's video. I am here to share a mid-2020, mid-year checkup on my goals. I put out a goals video at the beginning of the new year. I'll go ahead and link that video down below for you guys, where I talked all about the goals that I have for 2020. So it is halfway through the year. I can't believe it. And it's been a year. It's definitely been a year, but it is halfway through the year. And so I wanted to check in essentially and let you guys know how I'm doing on those goals that I set forward at the beginning of the year. Some of them are going great, some of them not so much, but I thought we would do a quick mid-year check-in. A lot of you have asked for this video, kind of wanting to know where I am in terms of the goals that I set, the vision board that I created, where am I halfway through the year. So without further ado, let's jump right in to those 2020 goals and how am I doing? The good, the bad, and the ugly. Goal for 2020, which was my big goal, my WW, my weight loss goal, was I wanted to lose 50 pounds in the year of 2020. So how have I been doing? Well, overall, I've been doing well. I've actually had a loss every single month since the beginning of the year. I'm seeing really good losses since my transition over to clean eating, which was in the month of February. I believe it was the very beginning of February. I am also going to be putting out a 6 months on clean eating expectations versus reality video. So stay tuned for that. It's going to be a good one. But since transitioning to clean eating, I've definitely seen an increase in my weight loss. I'm having more consistent losses every week. Are they 2 or 3 pounds a week? No, which I am okay with that. I've stated several times in my videos that I take this more as a journey, not a race. And I'm okay with 1 to 1.5 pounds a week weight loss. That way I'm still living my life. I'm enjoying my life. I get a splurge if I want here and there. And I get to eat real whole clean food, which makes me and my body extremely happy. So again, my goal was 50 pounds. So we're halfway through the year. So ideally, I'd like to have lost about 25 pounds by now. So as of the very end of May, I am down 17 pounds. So I'm about 8 pounds short of 25 pounds. Now that does not include the month of June. So I'm hoping to make up some of that ground this month in the month of June. That puts me 33 pounds from my 50 pound goal by the end of December. That means that on average, I need to lose a little over 4.5 pounds a month. And so far, I haven't done that. There's been 1 month that I lost 6 pounds, but other than that, I'm between like 3 and 5 pounds per month. In April, was a tough one. April, I actually only lost 1 pound overall. So that was definitely a setback in the big picture of the 50 pounds loss. But I can do it, you guys. I can definitely do it. So that is my goal. One of my main goals moving forward is to stay on track with that 4.5 to 5 pound minimum loss per month so that I can easily hit that 50 pounds by the end of 2020. Goal number two was to track honestly. This one is about 50-50. 50% of the time I track honestly, 50% of the time I don't track at all, or I'm not tracking every little thing that goes into my mouth. So I definitely have some work to be done on this goal. I'm happy with the 50%, but the other 50% needs a little bit of improvement. So another goal for the remainder of the year is to really focus on tracking a lot more honestly. I am tracking calories right now and points. I'm definitely tracking my calories honestly, but I'm not necessarily putting that number into the WW app every day. I've been a little more calorie focused. So that's where I could use a little bit of improvement. So I am going to track honestly, and we're gonna bump this up for 50% to 100%. The next goal was to work out 3 times per week. Now, before COVID, this was happening. It was more like 4 or 5 times a week. At the beginning of COVID, I was keeping up with that 3 times a week. And about the last, 2 or 3 weeks, life's just got in the way. And I'm either missing the mark completely on working out. And for working out, I mean jazzercise. That is the form of exercise that I love, that I've chosen. And there's been the last couple weeks where I haven't done any jazzercise workouts at all. Now, with that being said though, I'm still getting in a lot of steps. I've been doing a lot of workout in my yard. I've taken a few walks around my neighborhood, and with all of our camping trips, I'm getting 10 to 15,000 steps just in the course of camping every day, walking the dogs to and from the lake, to the store, just a lot of extra activity and movement when we're camping for the weekend. So not all is lost there, but I definitely am not consistently every single week getting in 3 times a week. So again, my goal is to focus more on this and guarantee myself 3 times a week of active, intentional movement. So for me, this is jazzercise and taking walks. I'm no longer going to be counting camping, even though I get a lot of steps. I am really going to focus on intentional exercise, aerobic exercise, where my heart rate is elevated for an extended period of time. So jazzercise or walks, I'm gonna do it. The next goal was 4 rollover points every day. This has been a huge fail. And let me go into that. I have not had rollovers at all since the beginning of the year, but I have changed my mind on this goal. This is no longer a goal that I'm going to be shooting for, and here's why. Since my transition over to clean eating, I am finding that I need to eat all of my points, and honestly, most of the time above my daily points, to be where I need to be calorically. Most whole, real food, not all, but most, tends to be a little bit higher in smart points, even though the caloric value of those foods isn't much more than a low fat or a full or a fat-free version. So for example, if I were to have Jif whips that were 140 calories, but only cost me 4 points, versus having real peanut butter or real nut butter that's 190 calories, but cost me 6 or 7 points, I'm finding that I'm needing to eat all of my points, and most days above that point bank, in order to be where I wanna be calorie-wise. So unfortunately, this goal is going to go to the wayside, because being where I need to be calorie wise is much more important to me. I do not want to do damage to my metabolism. I want to maintain my metabolism so I can continue to be successful losing weight. So bye to the 4 rollover goal. Next goal is 30,000 subscribers by the end of the year. If you remember, I hit 20,000 subscribers, or I'm sorry, 25,000 subscribers super, super quick within the first few months of the year. And that's just because everybody moving over to WW at the beginning of the year, New Year's resolutions, there's always an influx of people on any type of healthy eating or diet plan at the beginning of the year. I'm incredibly grateful for that. Since then, my sub count has slowed down a bit. As of right now, I am about 26,600 subscribers. So over the last couple months, I've gained about 1,600 to 1,700 subscribers, which is fantastic. But in order for me to reach my goal of 30,000 subscribers by the end of the year, I have 3,400 subscribers to go in order to hit that 30,000, which in essence is about 485 subscribers per month. Now, I could use your help on this. Share, like my channel, make sure you're subscribed. If you're watching this video, make sure you're subscribed. I did notice when I can go to my analytics page here on my channel that about 60% of my viewers are subscribed and 40% are not. Now, some of those 40% are my haters who won't subscribe. They simply watch my video to give it a thumbs down, which honestly, we don't need them in this channel. We don't want them. But those of you that aren't subscribed but still watch all my videos, make sure you subscribe, and better yet, hit the bell just so you're notified when new videos are uploaded. You can share my channel with others. A lot of you have shared my channel at your WW workshop or on Connect, which I greatly, greatly appreciate. So if you share and spread the news about my WW channel, there's a great positive possibility that will definitely hit that 30,000 subs by the end of the year. And that'll be a big giveaway. So it's a little bit of a win-win for both of us. My next goal on my vision board was to sell 12 houses. This is another pretty epic fail. With COVID, things in the real estate market for me really slowed down. I'm fairly new to selling real estate. I just got my license in August. I believe I've had just under 10 transactions since I started, which is fantastic, which is actually very, very abnormal. It normally takes 6 months before you even get a first transaction. And I had my first listing within a couple weeks. So I am so eternally grateful for that. But since the beginning of the year, I believe I've only had 3 transactions, and it's June. So I'm behind the ball. I should be about at least 6 transactions right now in order to be to the halfway point of meeting that goal. So again, if you guys are willing, I would love your help in reaching this goal as well. If you are in the state of Washington, hit me up. I'd be happy to help you buy or sell your home, especially if you're in the Spokane or the surrounding Spokane area. Now, I know that this is a very, very small amount of my subscribers. However, if you live in any other state or even on the other side of the state of Washington, you can help my business and help me reach these 12 houses sold by the end of the year by referring or allowing me to refer you to an agent in your area. So basically how it works is if you are going to buy or sell a home, you will reach out to me. I will do the legwork, the research to find you an agent in your state that is suited for you, that is high quality, best in class, and I will refer you to that agent. That agent will help you buy or sell your home, and in return, that agent pays me a referral fee for essentially referring you to them. That will help me a lot. I count referrals as houses sold because I do receive commission on that. It's a transaction that closes that somehow, some way I'm involved in. So if you are literally or anyone you know in the market to buy or sell, let me know and I will refer you to an agent in your area. And in no time, with all these wonderful people on my channel, we should be able to hit that 12 houses sold goal. So thank you in advance for giving me the opportunity to refer you if you're looking to buy or sell in your area. The next goal on my vision board is 52 weigh-ins, which essentially means that I'm weighing in every week, I'm filming a video, and I'm sharing that weigh-in with you. And so far, so good. I have done that every single week since the start of 2020, and I have no plans of changing that. Even if I'm camping on the weekend, I still weigh in, I still film a video, I still post it on Friday. So we are doing fantastic on that goal. In fact, you'll be seeing a weigh-in video this Friday as well. So that goal is going fantastic. The next goal on my vision board is to post my weight tracker. So basically I have essentially a monthly calendar. I'll insert a picture here for you guys where I track my overall weight loss for the month and I post this on my Instagram. I've done that every single month since the beginning of the year, even in April when I only lost 1 pound. I have been very consistent on filling this out and posting this for accountability. I'm proud of myself for this because I was terrible at it in 2019. So no matter what, the good, the bad, the ugly of the month, as far as overall weight loss goes, I'm still doing really well at posting that tracker on both my Instagram page and in my stories. And one last goal that actually isn't on my vision board, but is a goal that I shared in that goals video, is not to eat past 6 p.m. This has not been going well, you guys. I did much better with this goal in 2019 than I'm doing so far in 2020. I have great intentions. I eat my dinner. I have my snack. I track my points. I track my calories. I go watch TV or whatever it is that I do after dinner. And I find myself moving into the kitchen and grazing right around 7 o'clock or so. And if you didn't know, I'm like a grandma and I go to bed early, about 8 p.m. That needs to stop because there are days that I'm eating way above my points and calories by doing this little 7 p.m. graze into the kitchen. So as of today, starting today, I'm going to go back to what worked for me in 2019. And that is if I'm feeling hungry, not even hungry, snacky, cravy after dinner, after the 6 p.m. cutoff time, the only thing I can have is a cup of hot tea. And that actually works really well. It's flavor. I feel like I'm getting something sweet, a treat in my mouth, some flavorfulness for 0 points. So that is all that I am allowed after 6 p.m. starting today. Hold me to this, you guys. Ask me about this. Make sure that I stick with this goal because it is definitely really important for me to reach my weight loss goal. So no more snacking other than hot tea, unsweetened, after 6 p.m. All right, my friends, there are my mid-year 2020 goal updates. So with that being said, make sure you're checking out the video down in the description box that I filmed at the beginning of the year where I went over these goals. I made sure to insert pictures here of my vision board that sits right above the desk in my office that I see every day. Constant reminder of those 2020 goals. So overall, I feel like I'm doing really well. For the goals that really matter to me, for example, losing the 50 pounds, making sure that I'm posting that weight tracker for accountability, the subscribers here on my channel, working on my real estate career, those things are going overall pretty well. Unfortunately, there's a few other goals that I'd like to have going a little bit better that are not. And then of course, we are eliminating the 4 rollover goal just because it's just not conducive with my clean approach to WW. But overall, I'm proud of myself. I'm happy that I'm moving in a positive direction towards these goals overall. And I'm hoping that all of these goals will happen in the second half of 2020. So definitely stay tuned for the end of the year update on how things go. And of course, a new set of goals in the new year. If you're new to my channel, welcome. I'd love for you to stick around. I upload most days of the week, so make sure you hit the subscribe button and the little bell so you're notified when new videos are uploaded. Please make sure you're subscribed. That's gonna get us a lot closer to that subscriber goal for the end of the year. Also, give this video a thumbs up if you love these goal videos, these check-in videos, letting you guys know kind of how I'm doing on the goals that I put out. And of course, stay tuned for the 6-month update in the month of July on clean eating on WW. I'm gonna share the good, the bad, and the ugly for that as well. Thank you guys so much for spending some time with me today, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye, guys.